Grand Rising Loves, this is the altar spread for the collective today. Very powerful spread, but the same messages again. But I think you'll like this one. So transmutation showed up as the sacred geometry. This is the encompassing of all six-sided sacred geometry. But transmutation is the restructuring of DNA and energy. So the whole science of energy is that it cannot be created nor destroyed. It just always is. So it can be transmutated, it can be changed, it can be altered, alchemized. All of those things are the same. So transmutation talks about the imminent change that's happening, and that change is not always pleasant, but change is always inevitable. And so you are going through this initiation period, and if you are not doing the necessary things to get the end result that is necessary, then you're getting that assistance. And so if you're feeling like you're being tumbled right now, you are. And so that's like the rock going through the tumbler to become the gem. This is your refinement. It's not defining you, it is refining you. And so always remember to stay in that mindset when things seem like just out of control, like a runaway freight train. Know that it's all happening for you, not to you. And the end result is always going to be better than you can ever fathom. And so the ghost dance, and I love this, double fours, which is protection, and it's calling in all the elements. It's the harmonizing of our environment and self. And ghost dance, the double two, is all about relationship. And it could be intimate relationship, it could be work relationship, it could be friendships, but it's the harmonizing of those. So the ghost dance actually talks about our ancestors coming in for us. And ancestors are anyone that preceded you. Now there's some people that put themselves in a box and say, my ancestors are only my bloodline. That's not true. As ancient souls, ancestors are all that is. Okay? And so this is returning to unity consciousness, recognizing that everything is you. So anything that triggers the ego to be separate, right? Like, I'll just throw out some things that I've been witnessing. There's a lot of people that are advocating for against pedophilia. And yes, those children cannot defend themselves, and it is sick. It is not okay. Okay? But wasting your energy and time and self-avoiding to protest that is a distraction. Black Lives Matter is a distraction. There's a lot of other communities talking about cultural appropriation. That is a distraction. All of that is distraction. It is removing us from unity consciousness, and so that is purposely done. So stay conscious, stay aware. Get the fuck out of your ego. There is nothing separate from you. Everything that shows up is showing you either something that you need to heal in yourself, a shadow aspect of yourself, or something that you need to learn from. So everything outside of you is because of you. And when you realize that, things start to right themselves. Things start to right themselves. And I do a whole lot of work here at my altar for the collective. So I can feel what's playing out and what's happening in the collective. And I can feel the impediment of this huge ego, because even people who claim that they are conscious are completely in ego right now. And it's dense. It's gross. So I belong to a mastermind group on Sundays, and it's global, and there's a group of psychics, and we all gather together and we join our mind to create a mastermind so that we can heal something in the collective. And I can always tell who's in ego by the suggestions that come up on what we should heal. And that's supposedly a very high level of consciousness group. But and I see people, it's almost like the more followers they have, the bigger their ego. And I'm like, okay. And it's all right. I know that all of that's happening for our purpose too. But we cannot return to unity consciousness in that mindset. You have to get the fuck out of your ego. There's nothing outside of you. And as teachers of consciousness, they should be more aware of that. And they should be ashamed of themselves perpetuating expired paradigms. But Ghost Dance showed up to say, your ancestors have a message for you, but you are too polluted by ego to hear them. So quiet your mind, create a sacred space so that they have access to you. So like here, my altar, this is a sacred space that my higher guides have access to me here. But I am in a constant state of presence and awareness. So I can go through my day as the conduit that I am, as a sacred conduit where I'm doing divine work for the collective on a constant basis. But anytime that you go into ego, it creates blocks. Celestite has the same message, but not necessarily ancestors. This talks specifically about angels and spirit messengers. And so Celestite helps facilitate that. And so this is Celestite. And I love sharing this one because it looks like a heart. Isn't that beautiful? This is Celestite. It helps facilitate the lines of communication between you and your guides, angels, ascended masters. And so that also says the same thing. There are messages that are ready for you, but you're not able to hear them because of ego. You're too busy, you're too in your head, you're too caught up in programming that you're not getting the real messages and guidance that you need. So things are gonna feel very out of control. They're gonna be difficult for you. They're going to be confusing for you because you're not quieting the ego to listen. And so that's what Celestite says. So through the transmutation, you're going to have to create a sacred space for yourself to commune with self. And that's what I've been talking about, getting back to yourself so that you can be propelled through the human experience with clarity. And that's very important. And so Lena showed up, what must be shall be. And so this talks about the maturing of the spiritual self. And that's what happens in transmutation, that you do mature. But the maturity can only happen through light and darkness. So you have to go through very dark events to learn from them. And so it's saying, if that's what's happening right now, please know that you will come into the light again. So do not lose hope. Always stay with the mindset that you are a divine being and deserving of all that is abundant and beautiful. Because unity consciousness is love. Love is the only truth. And so if you are seeing things as outside of yourself and you are in a constant state of venting, ranting, you have a cause, you feel like you're in competition, you feel threatened, all of those things are expired paradigm. Unity consciousness, there is only love, and love never wanes in unity consciousness. Love is all that exists, and there is nothing outside of you. And that's where we're headed. And if it can't be done, because too many people are holding on to the expired paradigms, because they think that the position they're in is lofty and beautiful, then we will all be eradicated. Just like biblical times. So that's what's headed our way. And so, yeah, just quiet the ego so that you can get the messages that are meant for you. Get out of those expired paradigms. Let yourself be guided to unity consciousness, because it's way better than you can ever fathom. Thank you. I love you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for any part of me that created separateness. Please forgive me. Thank you.